Ukraine is a country in Eastern Europe. Ukraine borders Russia to the east and northeast, Belarus to the northwest, Poland, Slovakia and Hungary to the west, Romania and Moldova to the southwest, and the Black Sea and Sea of Azov to the south and southeast, respectively. It has an area of 603,628 kilometers to 233,062 square miles, making it the largest country entirely within Europe. Armenians in Ukraine. Armenians in Ukraine are ethnic Armenians who live in Ukraine. They number 99,894 according to the 2001 Ukrainian census. Many Crimean Armenians moved further to the northwest to the already flourishing Armenian communities, which gradually integrated into the local Polish population while maintaining their distinct identity through the Armenian Catholic Church. In the 18th century, Crimea fell under influence of the Russian Empire. Armenian communities can also be found in Dnipropetrovsk, Kharkiv, Kherson, Kiev, Luhansk, Mykolaiv, Zaporizhzhia, and Odessa, where the late Ukrainian Armenian artist Sargis Orzaian spent most of his life. Armenian Cathedral of Elvis. The Armenian Cathedral of the Assumption of Mary in Elvis, Ukraine is located in the city's old town, north of the Market Square. Until 1945, it was a cathedral of the Armenian Catholic Archdiocese of Elvis. Since 2000, it serves as a cathedral of the Eparchy of Ukraine of the Armenian Apostolic Church. Is no longer consecrated to the Pope. Because of the Armenians, after many vicissitudes, there are only very few. Nowadays it is used as a concert hall. Architecture is typical of the Armenian building. In August of 2004, on the occasion of the 350th anniversary of Kharkov, the supreme patriarch of all Armenians solemnly consecrated the St. Herodian Armenian Apostolic Church, the foundation stone of which had been put as far back as on July 1, 2000. An Armenian cultural center was also built next to the church, and today it looks these buildings are built with Armenian pink people. Sarkis Ordayan, December 28, 1918 to 2003, was a Ukrainian-Armenian painter. He was born at unknown parents in the village of Ajizdar, in the Shamshagan region of Armenia, now part of the Tadish province. Developments apply to the Crimean Peninsula, a multi-ethnic region of Ukraine comprising the autonomous republics of Crimea and Sevastopol, both populated by an ethnic Russian majority and a large minority of ethnic Ukrainians and Crimean Tatars. The demographics of Crimea have undergone dramatic changes in the past. As a result of the 2014 Crimean crisis and the accompanying Russian military intervention, sovereignty over the peninsula is currently disputed between Ukraine and the Russian Federation. The peninsula is now de facto controlled by the Russian Federation in the form of two federal subjects, the Republic of Crimea and the federal city of Sevastopol. Crimea was a part of the Byzantine Empire, with Armenians as its subjects, moving here from various cities of the empire. The region's stability allowed them to achieve economic prosperity, uninterrupted even in the face of the Mongolian invasion. Their numbers totaled around 9,000 and 14,000 to 15,000 in 1914. The resettlement of Armenians in the peninsula lasted until the First World War and the Armenian Genocide in the Ottoman Empire in 1915-1923. In 1989, the communal life of Crimean Armenians was institutionalized with the formation of one of the peninsula's first national cultural associations, the Armenian Beliefs Light Society. Later, after re-registration in 1996. March 3, 2014. Representative of Armenian community of Simferopol described situation in Crimea as calm. There are no tanks in the streets of Simferopol, Yalta, or elsewhere in Crimea. Vagarshav Melkonyan told Armenian News. Melkonyan noted that the official position of the Armenian community of Crimea coincides with that of Armenian community of Ukraine. Armenians are neutral and stand for peace and stability in the country. We are for peace for all nations living in Crimea, he added. One of Crimea's most famous Armenians was painter Hodei Anton Vagarsky, renowned for his seascapes such as the Ninth Wave, 1850. The Armenians were mostly adherents of the Armenian Apostolic Church. There were a number of churches built in Yalta, Theodosia, and Yekatoria. Construction activity took place from the 14th century, and according to one manuscript, the monastery of Kamchap had been built by the 15th century in Kanva. Բաշակները եկեք մենք կենաց հայերի Բաշակները եկեք մենք կենաց հայերի The second largest Armenian population after Kapa in the same period was Sirkak. The name Sirkak is probably a distorted form of the name of the Armenian monastery Sirkech Holy Cross. There were many Armenian churches, schools, neighborhoods here as well.
Asknurana yevainas darna Aina hayavor asknurana yevainas darna Makvalorin hayartsunkin acharjanana Makvalorin Անդրանիկի սերոպաշին գևորգ չավուշին Քրիստափորին կաչրոցտոնին Ուզավարյանի
In the city of Adana, during the darkest days of the Ottoman Empire, there began a tragedy that marked the start of what was to become known as the Armenian Genocide. The people of Armenia were forced into starvation, torture, and extermination. Armenian homes were burned to the ground. Men, women, and children were killed. Sometimes, entire families were wiped out. They were accused, convicted, and and sentenced to die because they dared to call themselves Christians. Their crime was in believing in a God who sent his Son, Jesus Christ, to die for their sins. By 1950, 1.5 million Armenians were ruthlessly slaughtered because they would not renounce their faith in Christ. Unpunished and undeterred, the ones responsible for the massacre in Adana set the stage for the terrible genocide of the Armenian people. This is their story. Though persecuted, they were not abandoned. As they laid down their earthly lives, they would gain eternity with Christ. Though the world may forget, God would remember their suffering. Never again would they hunger or thirst. For the Son of God, Jesus Christ, who died and rose again, would be their shepherd. He would lead them to springs of living water, and God would wipe away every tear from their eyes. They would encircle the throne of God, singing to the great I Am, "Worthy is the Lamb who was and is to come."